Today's topic is, first, why to use RCCB circuit breaker at 30 milliampere trip current type only in the house. Second point is, if 30 milliampere type cannot be used somewhere, then what to do? Every RCCB has two basic types of current rating. First is residual current or trip current, which is written as I delta N also. This current rating may be 30 milliampere, may be 100 milliampere, may be 300 milliampere. Second type of rating is rated current, written as IN. This is the current which flows in the contact, or the maximum current which can flow in the load. This may be 16 ampere, or 25 ampere, or 32 ampere, or 40 ampere. You can select the combination. You can take a RCCB of 30 milliampere type trip current and 25 ampere rated current. Or you can select 30 milliampere trip current and 32 ampere rated current. Combinations are there. Today we will not discuss about this rated current. Today we will discuss about this current. This is the residual current when this flows in the RCCB, RCCB breaker will trip. RCCB circuit breaker is used to protect the human body from electrical shock. Now, how much current a body can take safely? This is shown in this plot. This is unsafe area. This is current in the body. This is the time for which current flows in the body. You see here, if current is more, then it can flow only for short time. If current in the body is less, say here, then it can flow for longer time. It is allowed for longer time. Now this we know plot, but how do we decide that how much current, 30 milliampere or 100 milliampere, to be selected for RCCB? So I will explain you something new for this. Now, which milliampere type RCCB to be selected? Maybe we do not know due to lack of knowledge. Everybody does not have knowledge. I have worked for 35 years in design department. I do not know many things. That time what we do? We refer standards. These standards are actually technical documents which are made by technical experts. Anybody can use that. You can gain knowledge from those standards. Second thing is, whatever written in those technical documents, it is necessary that all should follow that. These technical documents are not available in open market. So next slide, what I am going to show, the data is taken from these standards. Now as per standard, RCCB breaker trip requirement for human safety is as per this plot. This indicates the residual current flowing in the RCCB in milliampere. This is the time taken by RCCB to trip. Now, if residual current is 240 milliampere, then RCCB must trip in less than 50 milliseconds. If residual current is 80 milliampere, then RCCB must trip in less than 150 milliseconds. This is millisecond. Similarly, if residual current is 30 milliampere, then RCCB must trip in less than 500 milliseconds. This chart indicates these three points only. This is current flow in human body through RCCB, and this is RCCB must trip in less than this much time. This point indicates this 250 milliampere and 50 millisecond. This point is this 80 milliampere, 150 millisecond, and this point is this 30 milliampere, 500 millisecond. This indicates approximately. I was not able to read exactly 500 millisecond in the plot which I saw, so I have shown approximately. Now, to meet this time requirement, 30 milliampere RCCB is used. 100 milliampere type or 300 milliampere type RCCB will not trip as per this chart. 30 milliampere RCCB is made to meet this requirement for human safety. So we use 30 milliampere type RCCB in-house for human safety. Now these are the data for RCCB with current trip 30 milliampere type. This is residual current and this is trip time. Now if it is 30 milliampere type, then RCCB must trip in less than 300 millisecond. If current is less than 15 milliampere, then it should not trip. Suppose current flowing in RCCB is 5 milliampere, residual current 5 milliampere, then it should not trip. So this RCCB 30 milliampere type can trip for a current range of 15 to 30 milliampere. Some may trip at 30 milliampere, some at 25, some at 20. Some variation will be there. If residual current becomes double, 60 milliampere, the time will come down, trip time will come down to 150 millisecond. Similarly, if residual current is 150 milliampere, then RCCB must trip within 40 millisecond. This is also as per standard. Now suppose 30 milliampere type RCCB has problem of frequent tripping. We are not touching electrical wire. No leakage current is flowing in our body. Still it is tripping. It is because of leakage in many industrial equipment or in case of very big loads. When loads are very big, then there may be leakage in those and it may trip. Then what to do? Then we use 300 milliampere type RCCB. But in this case, this RCCB will not give protection to human. It will not protect us from electrical shock. Then what we do? At incomer we use this. Then we divide the loads. There may be many loads, small. So for every small load we provide one 30 milliampere type RCCB. Here I have shown three. There may be four or five. These RCCB will provide protection to human. If we have big building, in that there are many flats, then incomer may have this type and every flat may have 30 milliampere type RCCB. This 30 milliampere type RCCB are used in houses for human safety to protect the human from electrical shock. 300 milliampere type RCCB is used for fire protection in industry and commercial buildings. Or if you have problem just now we discussed, then we can use 300 milliampere type, but then both type we will have to use.